हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ रिसर्च डिजाइन इन डिटेल। फॉलोइंग पॉइंट्स वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इन डिटेल विथ डिफरेंट एग्जांपल्स इन ईच एंड एवरी पॉइंट। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड मीनिंग ऑफ रिसर्च डिजाइन। रिसर्च डिजाइन इज द फ्रेमवर्क ऑफ रिसर्च मेथड्स एंड टेक्निक्स चूजन बाय अ रिसर्चर। अ रिसर्च डिजाइन लेज द फाउंडेशन फॉर कैरिंग आउट द प्रोजेक्ट। A good research design will ensure that the research project is carried out effectively and efficiently. So now, let us study in detail classification of research design. Type 1. Exploratory research. Exploratory research is defined as research used to investigate a problem which is not clearly defined. It is conducted to have a better understanding of the existing problem, but will not provide conclusive results. For such research, a researcher starts with a general idea and uses this research as a means to identify problems that may be the focus of future research. This investigation is generally carried out when the problem is in a preliminary stage. For example, the owner of the juice bar believes that increasing the variety of juices will increase the number of customers. However, he is not sure and needs more information. The owner intends to conduct exploratory research to find out whether expanding the juice selection will allow him to gain more customers or not. Following are three different ways through which we can do exploratory research: focus group, case study, and in-depth interview. Number 1. Focus group. In this method, a group of people is chosen and allowed it to express their ideas on the subject under study. However, it is important to ensure that when choosing people in a focus group, they must have common backgrounds and comparable experiences. For example, a focus group helps researcher to identify the opinions of consumers if they would buy a phone. Such research can help the researcher understand what the consumer values when buying a phone. It can be the size of the screen, the brand value, or even the dimensions, from which the organization can understand the buying attitudes and opinions of consumers. Number 2. Case study method. Case study research can help researcher to find out more information by carefully analyzing existing cases that have experienced a similar problem. The investigator just needs to make sure to analyze the case carefully in regards to all variables present in the previous case against his own case. It is widely used by business organizations or the social science sector or even in the health sector. For example, a particular orthopedic surgeon has the highest success rate for performing knee surgeries. Many other hospitals or doctors have dealt with this case to understand and compare the method in which this surgeon performs the procedure to increase his success rate. Number 3. In-depth interview. You can get a lot of information from public sources, but sometimes in-depth interview can provide detailed information on the topic being studied. An interview with a subject matter expert can provide you with valuable information that a general public source will not be able to provide. In-depth interviews are conducted in person or by phone, which have open-ended questions to obtain meaningful information on the topic. For example, an interview with an employee can give you more insight to find out the degree of job satisfaction. Type 2. Descriptive research. Descriptive research is a type of research that provides an in-depth description of the phenomenon or population under study. This methodology focuses more on the what of the research subject than the why of the research subject. Descriptive research is a good option if you want to know the trends in a particular field or the frequency of an event. For example, a clothing brand that wants to understand fashion trend among Indian shoppers will conduct a demographic survey of this region, collect population data, and then conduct descriptive research on this demographic segment. Following are two different ways through which we can do descriptive research: cross-sectional design, longitudinal design. Number 1. Cross-sectional design. A cross-sectional study is a type of research design in which data is collected from many different people at one time. The data collected comes from a group of participants with varied characteristics and demographics known as variables: age, gender, income, education, geographic location are examples of variables. For example, healthcare industry. Scientists in healthcare might use cross-sectional research to understand how children aged between 2 to 12 across India are prone to calcium deficiency. Number 2. Longitudinal design. In a longitudinal study, researchers repeatedly examine the same individuals for any changes that may occur over a period of time. Longitudinal study are a type of correlational research in which researchers observe and collect data on a number of variables without trying to influence them. This type of study can take place over a period of weeks, months, or even years. In some cases, longitudinal studies can last several decades. For example, a longitudinal study of children with Down syndrome could involve study of 100 children with this condition from birth to 10 years of age. Type 3. Causal research. Causal research can be defined as a research method used to determine the cause and effect relationship between two variables. This research is primarily used to identify the cause of the given behavior. Using causal research, we decide what variation takes place in an independent variable with the change in the dependent variable. For example, a cereal brand owner wants to know if he will get more sales with his new cereal box design. He would set up an experiment in two separate stores. One will sell the cereal only in its original box and the other with the new box. They would then measure the difference between the sales based on the packaging of the cereal. Following are three different ways through which we can do causal research: one-shot study, before-after with control group, before-after without control group. Number 1. One-shot case study. The one-shot case study is a research design in which a single group is observed on a single occasion after experiencing some event, treatment, or intervention. For example, the researcher wants to evaluate the effect of counseling session on the attitude of the school children. Number 2. Before-after without control group. In this design, a single group or test area is selected and the dependent variable is measured before introduction of treatment. Then the treatment is introduced and the dependent variable is measured again after the treatment has been introduced. For example, we know the sales made by the salespeople for a specific period. Now we provide them training for a specific period and then we measure sales. Therefore, the comparison of sales made after training with sales made during the corresponding period before training. Number 3. Before-after with controlled group. In controlled before-after studies, outcomes are measured before and after a treatment in a group that receives the treatment and in another group that does not receive the treatment or that receives a different treatment. The idea is that any confounding factor would impact both groups equally, and therefore any difference in the data drawn from the two groups can be attributed to the experimental variable. For example, measurement of impact of a sugar beet seed production on brand awareness. First two groups would be matched. Attributes such as types of farm, dependency ratio for hand tools, etc. would match with each group, so that the groups are interchangeable for the purpose of the test. Friends, thank you for watching my video. If you like my video, then please subscribe to my channel Management by Dr. Mitul Dhimmer and share my videos. Thank you.